You may think in order to lose belly fat that you have to restrict yourself from all the foods that you love, follow a rigid eating pattern, and discipline yourself harshly in order to accomplish those goals. Well, the fact is that mentality that I just mentioned is exactly why you'll fail at losing belly fat and accomplishing your goals. And in fact, it'll even cause you to yo-yo diet, where you'll lose a whole bunch of weight and then gain it all back and some. In this video, I'm going to share with you a sustainable practice to not only lose belly fat, but do it without dieting. It's amazing to me that people eat so unhealthy that as soon as you start making better food choices, people consider you to be on a diet. It seems so obvious when we look at our pets. It's obvious we shouldn't feed our cat Doritos and we shouldn't feed our dog donuts. Why is that? Simply because it's not the right food for their species type. And we know that if we feed them the correct food, they'll effortlessly not have weight gain issues, they will not have problems with chronic disease at a young age, things will just work out. Well, the fact is, the same goes for you. And this is why it's so important to understand these simple concepts I'm about to teach you, so that you can also lose belly fat effortlessly. Now, here's the thing too. Losing belly fat isn't about exhaustive runs on the treadmill or being super strict. It's 100% about finding a sustainable way of living that you can maintain day in and day out that will give you the shape and figure that you want. I've worked with thousands of patients and I've seen the same practices that cause people to fail play out again and again. So here's how to fix them. Let's first start with creating a proper mindset. Now, just like we mentioned before, it's not healthy for your pets to eat processed junk food. Turns out, it's also not healthy for you to eat processed junk food. So what I want you to do is ask yourself, every time when you go to eat something, ask yourself if that particular food is going to create a state of health in your body or if it's going to create a state of disease. This alone will give you a lot of answers. The next thing I want you to do is identify your food weaknesses. Now, let me give you an example. I recently started working with a lady, and she was telling me that the diet is going to be very difficult for her to keep up with because she's not going to be able to eat the foods that she loves. Now, she's Italian, and what is it that Italians like to eat? You guessed it. Pizza and pasta. Now, mentally, she was totally overwhelmed because she would have to follow this diet, giving up the two major foods that she really loved to eat that were a staple in her diet. Now, I went on to tell her that I wanted her to continue eating all the foods that she loved, and I want you to do the same. Now, this is where you're probably a little bit confused, and she got really confused. She goes, "I can eat pizza and pasta on the diet?" I go, "Absolutely, but here's what I want you to do. I want you to find the healthier alternatives." So for instance, if we look at pizza, what's unhealthy about a pizza? Well, it's the crust, right? So we have options. We can find an almond flour crust pizza. We can even find a cauliflower crust pizza. And then there you have it. You're able to eat pizza in a healthy way. Well, what about pasta, you might ask? Well, the same thing. I asked her to eat either a lentil noodle pasta or a zucchini noodle pasta. And if she was able to go and make those changes, eating those foods that she loved, but eating healthier versions of them, then she would lose belly fat and be able to sustainably maintain that weight loss. These are the same strategies I use in my own personal life in order to help me lose belly fat. And in fact, we all have these foods that we really enjoy, and sometimes they're not that healthy for us. And unfortunately, they're not gonna help us lose weight at all. So what I want you to do, and here's my challenge to you, is think about the foods that you eat most commonly throughout the day that are unhealthy. Those are the ones that are gonna ruin your mentality and give you a lot of trouble. After you identify those foods, find a healthier option that you're gonna be very satisfied with and replace them. Then and only then, you'll be able to have the proper mentality to sustainably follow a diet that will help you lose belly fat every day. And from here on out, there's no more harsh calorie restriction diets, there's no more eating tasteless salads from weeks on end, and there's no more being miserable. You can lose belly fat sustainably and enjoy the entire process. Now, another way that we're going to accomplish this goal of losing belly fat without dieting is going to be to stop snacking. There is no doubt when you are snacking all day long, you are eating a tremendous amount of calories in very small amounts and not even realizing that that really adds up towards the end of the day. And it causes two problems for us. First of all, we end up overeating every single day. And the other one is that we are constantly stimulating the fat storage hormone insulin all day long. And if we want to lose belly fat, we cannot be increasing a fat storage hormone. It's just going to be very counterintuitive and it won't work out for us. So what you need to do is, if you're someone who eats 3 meals a day, then you'll simply eat your meal and not snack in between. Or maybe you're someone who's eating 2 meals a day. And if this is the case, you just eat your meal and be done. No snacking in between. Now let's review what times you're eating, because this is really important. And when I say what times you're eating, I don't care about how early in the morning you eat or how late at night you eat. The one thing that really matters is the duration of time throughout the day in which you consume food. Now, unfortunately, in today's society, we find ourselves grazing all the time. You wake up in the morning and you have breakfast and then lunch and dinner and snacks in between and dessert, you name it. Well, what we want to do is we want to consume our food within an 8-hour period, 8 hours or less. And what this allows for is our metabolism to reset, our insulin levels, that fat storage hormone, to drop really low for us to become more insulin sensitive. And then the other thing that this will do is this will help push us into a fat burning state. Consuming all of your meals within an 8 hour or less period will give your body the ability to burn belly fat. And it's these simple tweaks that you can make that will really set you up for success. This next strategy I'm about to share with you is one that some will deem controversial and many people will wildly disagree with me on. And that is that counting calories is a form of dieting that is completely dead, right? Counting calories is frustrating. You have to write down the amount of calories you consume every day. You have to plan out your meals. It takes a lot of time and effort that busy people, or maybe even those who have families, young children, just do not have time to implement into their day. But what does work, and works very effectively, is constructing a fast day into your week, week after week, in order to lose belly fat. Let me give you an example. So I recommended earlier that we eat your meals within a 8 hour time frame. And that allows you to intermittent fast daily. It helps reset your metabolism and drive down insulin and put yourself into that fat burning state. One of the things that you can do that acts as a hard reset to your metabolism and boosts your metabolism over time, along with really driving you deep into that fat burning state, is doing a 24 hour fast weekly. Now, there's a couple ways that you can implement fasting into your weekly schedule. Some people will do a 24 hour fast once a week. Others will do a 48-hour fast every other week. And then there's some that'll do a 3-day water fast at least once a month. And that's what I prefer to do personally. I recently shared a video on my channel where I did a 3-day water fast and I actually did body scans and I was able to determine that I would lose a ton of body fat and I maintained my muscle. So I went from 17% body fat down to 14% body fat without losing any muscle at all. So when it comes to losing belly fat, there's not a better way to do it than fasting, whereas calorie restriction will tend to not only cause you to lose fat, but also muscle mass as well. So I recommend that you do more fasting and less calorie restricting and less calorie counting. We'll talk more about how you can burn belly fat in just one moment, but first I'm excited to announce we just launched a brand new membership community where you'll find lots of exclusive content, like me recently getting my blood drawn and checking my antibodies a year and a half after getting the virus, and breaking down for you natural immunity versus acquired immunity and which one scientifically is proven to work better at this point. The other thing that we do is group challenges, like a 3-day group water fast. We do lives where you can submit your questions directly and I'll answer them for you. In this community, we have a lot of fun, but most importantly, it supports the most cutting edge natural health content so that we can continue to create great information for you. Make your way on over to drz.tv and become a supporter today. Now let's talk about movement, because this is something that is no doubt very important for the human body and is very important for us to maintain good health. And it is so amazing how we can go through our days in modern society and have almost zero movement. I mean, it happens to me and I'm sure it happens to you. Recently I was traveling and at the end of the day I was exhausted, but then when I thought about my day, it's like, well, I, you know, was on my commute to the airport, I sat at the airport, I sat in the plane for hours on end and then commuted home and sat some more. I had almost no physical activity. And if you think about somebody who's working at a desk job, it happens many, many days of the week. And so it's important to make sure that we recognize when our physical activity is really low. If you're not physically exercising throughout the day, it's very important that you find ways to implement activity in any way possible. Maybe it's parking a little bit further away from work and walking in. bed. Maybe it's taking the stairs instead of the elevator, or even at your lunch break, instead of sitting down and eating for 45 minutes, grab something quick to eat and go for a nice walk. At the very least, you want to make sure that you're implementing at least a 30-minute brisk walk in every single day. It'll be very, very difficult to lose belly fat and maintain good health if you are not getting exercise in. Exercise is an essential nutrient to the body. It is absolutely required for our DNA. Now, in order for you to get the best results and be able to lose that belly fat without having to focus on dieting, there's a few other areas I really need you to focus on. The first is going to be to not drink your calories. Focus on eating your calories, but not drinking them. Stick to zero calorie beverages in order to help you along with your goals. The next thing is to stay sugar-free whenever possible. If you have a sweet tooth, look to things like stevia, monk fruit, xylitol, and you can even use erythritol. Now, after that, make sure that you're not falling into the trap of the cheat day, right? Because it only takes one day of the week to screw up all your hard work that you put in. I recently had a patient that couldn't lose weight, couldn't lose the belly fat. It turns out the weekends were cheat days. Well, we had to stop that, and as soon as we did, they were getting results again. The other thing I want you to really realize throughout this entire process is that you're going to screw up, okay? And that's okay. When you screw up, reset, recalibrate, re-engage, get focused, and get back on track. And that is what will ultimately help you have a sustainable process in losing belly fat. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this one, I really think that you'll like this video over here.